calculations behind the simple waterfall chart, and we will just try to make that interview. Then waterfall chart colored by segment. As last week we have discussed more about waterfall chart, I thought it would make sense if we then like how to make that aspect. And the waterfall chart colored by segment, like already we saw in the last week, right, in Google. And at last we will just try to find like analysis behind a feature in e-commerce sites. So what is that, and how do we do that tab? So all these three we'll try to learn today. This is the objective. So yes. So simple waterfall chart, as we have discussed already, here in this visualization, across the time period, how the sales has been, and yeah. So what are the steps involved? If you look back into this, we can just see there was a running sum behind the metric whichever you want to create. That's represented by this black line, and the metric which is below, that's the particular, like for the particular month, what is the sales or profit, that's the blue color indicator. These are the two steps involved. So first one is running sum of your metric, which will be the black line, and additive inverse of the metric in size, that represent this blue. I will just explain why the additive inverse in more detail while making in that. Yeah. So as usual, we are connecting to the sample superstore data, and yes. So whatever metric you want to show the waterfall chart across the sales or profit, whatever the metric, just here we'll try to show the waterfall chart among the sales and the order date. So just I'm putting order date into columns, month of order date. Okay. Alright. Yeah. Month, then some sales. Convert this into yen chart, and instead of sum of sales, we'll just add a quick table calculation and running total. So now we got the black head whichever you want. And in second step, I mentioned like we have to put the sum sales in size, but additive inverse. Why? Because we'll also do a dual action, and this one we'll change the color black and increase the size to so why we have to just add the negative additive inverse in size, because already if you see here, the sales is like from 0 to 14,237. But currently, if you view the visualization, here or somewhere, what's happening is the sales, the sum sales is added just above the line, whichever we wanted. So what we have to do, if we add the additive inverse, why we have to do that is so that we will just get below the line whichever we add. Just remove the size, then press back, and increase the size. Now just do the real add. So now you see currently like the black line represents the running total, and the blue represents the additive inverse whichever we added. Even if you see in tooltip, it's like minus 55,691. This is because here our objective is to get the sales below the line. So in order to get that, we have to add the negative, like additive inverse of the metric whichever we would like to show. In that way, we will get below the line, and it makes sense. Add just the sum of sales. What happens here is the sum of sales will come, but it will be showing just above the black line, like whichever you have added, which is not correct. So in order to get rid of this, we'll just add additive inverse. Just negative of some sales, whatever we have done. So this is the first waterfall chart. Any doubts?
No.
Okay. So if you do bit more far printing than it looks. Currency custom, and there is no need of decimals also. We'll just try to. So yeah, next we will just see like how to show the sum of sales across the sum of sales or profit across the segment. So first, as same. Like maybe you can duplicate the same and work on. So as usual, like we have shown the sales and we got the simple waterfall chart. To add the segment into picture, just pull the segment. So what it happens here is maybe if we convert this to duplicate as cross tab. Running, we'll remove the sales and we'll just do the sales index. And if you see here, the segment it's not at all considering. For each segment, if you see 6928 is in Jan 28, it's just adding up the 3618 and it's showing for each month. So currently, the table calculation is happening only across the month but not across the segment. So in order to ensure that the calculation happens across segment as well, what we have to do is like just go here and edit table calculation. If you select specific dimension and if you select segment, you can make sure here the total sales is like 14,231 across the Jan 2020. And if you directly look consumer February, what are the total 14,237? Along with this, like $3,168, this is also getting adding up, and the table calculation is starting from here and it goes down then across. So earlier what it was happening is it was not considering the segment, only across the odd date it was just taking the running sum of the sales. But once you selected table segment, so that ensures that take segment also into account. So in this way we can just we'll be able to neglect the gap in between each bars. So whatever we have done there, we'll do the same here. So edit table calculation, specific dimension and segment. So now we got the running waterfall chart for the sales, but it's like even colored by segment. For battery, you will just pull the month to filter and we'll just filter it and show only the last 2 years. So the catch here is once you pull the metric, like whichever you like to show it by color, you have to make sure the table calculation even considered those segments as well. That's the catch here.